Centurion versus Infinity Inhard Cataract. This is a video presentation to compare between the two machines. This is the Centurion machine and the Infinity machine. This is done in the same patient with the same density of cataract by transferring the video overlay between the two machines and splitting each step into two parts using each machine. As you can see, we are using the Infinity now for the sculpting. Torsional 100, 0 longitudinal power. Then using the Centurion machine, we lower our setting to 60% only torsional. The vacuum increased from 100 in Infinity to 200 in Centurion. Still stable anterior chamber. Then doing the back vertical cracking for the quadrant removal. Here we are using the Brown intracapsular manipulator. We are embedding into the cortex, go around the nucleus to the equator and then cracking from behind. Here the vacuum is 500. We are using longitudinal 10% linear and torsional 60% linear. Then the Infinity machine, the vacuum is 350, torsional 100, and the amplitude of the torsional FACO is also 100. As you can see, the CDE is increasing dramatically in the Infinity machine more than the Centurion machine. You can see there is a surge with the Infinity machine, which was not evident in Centurion machine. Filling the bag with viscoelastic. We are using the methyl cellulose for the whole procedure and only the helium for the implantation. Here, as you can see, there is surge. Now, completing the last piece with the Centurion. As you can see, the AC is stable. Capsular bag is stable. Then doing the cortical removal. This is manual assisting for removal of the cortex and even nucleus. Then using the bimanual irrigation aspiration to clean the cortical material from the capsular bag. Then implantation of the intraocular lens. Loading it to the cartridge. And using the Royal injector, as you can see. So you can use both hands as the second instruments will protect from jumping of the intraocular lens. Then cleaning the viscoelastic with IA. As you can see, there is a difference in the CDE, 17 in Infinity and only 10 in Centurion. So there is a big difference between the two machines, as you can see. Now the second case is comparing the two machines in pseudo-exfoliation heart cataract. After dilating the pupil with iris hooks, doing the capsular axis. As you can see, if you are seeing the capsular axis edge, you can just complete it without staining. Same with the same technique, doing the sculpting, central sculpting, also torsional 60 in the Centurion machine. And with Infinity machines, the torsional is 100. Vacuum is 200 in Centurion and 100 in Infinity. Then the quadrant removal was also 10% Fico power, longitudinal power, and 100 torsional amplitude. The vacuum is 350 linear. Now we raise the longitudinal power to 20 and making the IB active or intelligent FACO because it is a hard cataract. As you can see, the AC is not stable. There is a lot of surges. Reforming the AC with viscoelastic, which is methyl cellulose, rotating the nucleus, using the Centurion machine now. The longitudinal power is 10 and the torsional is 60, vacuum is 500, IB is on also to compare between the two machines. In both machines, we are using the gravity, not the active fluidics, to make it comparable to each other. As you can see, the AC is stable, more stable than the Infinity. FACO emulsifying the last piece is protecting of the posterior capsule by the second anastomosis. Even nucleus and cortical removal can use the same setting as you can see. And then cleaning the cortex by IA by manual irrigation aspiration. Now you can see, in comparing the two machines, the Centurion is more effective, as you can see, with a difference of 6 in CDE. So the Centurion machine is much more better than the Infinity machine. Thanks.